यस सर।
ओके फाइन। सो यस वी विल स्टार्ट राइट नाउ। सो हियर वी डिस्कस इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम। ओके सो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम इज नथिंग बट देर आर डिफरेंट बैंड्स विच आर डिवाइडेड एज पर द डिफरेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंजेस। ओके सो दोज बैंड्स आर नथिंग बट रेडियो बैंड, माइक्रोवेव बैंड, इंफ्रारेड, अल्ट्रावायलेट, एक्सरे, गैमा रेज एंड सो ऑन। ओके सो व्हाई, व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ ऑल दिस बैंड्स? सो ऑल दिस बैंड्स आर नथिंग बट these bands are having the different frequency ranges. So different frequency ranges means we know the basic concept why we are using the frequencies or these different frequency ranges. So these different frequency ranges means by with the help of electromagnetic waves we are transmitting the data from the transmitter to receiver, right? And these, when we are transmitting the data from transmitter to receiver by using the electromagnetic waves, so these electromagnetic waves are having the different frequencies. So we already discussed about this one, and we know the definition of frequency. Frequency is nothing but it is a number of cycles per second. Okay, so here if you observe this diagram, so here we have just on PPT I shown the electromagnetic spectrum. So here the different bands are having the different frequencies. So different bands are having the different frequencies, and with the help of this frequency we are transmitting the data. Okay, so why I am repeating same thing again and again? Because on the basis of this frequency the rest of the part of communication is depend. Means if you have the higher frequency, then it will affect the antenna height, it will affect the quality of service, it will affect the your amplification process. So frequency is important one. And in previous lecture we just know that this electromagnetic wave is having the two components. So that is the one on the first one, that is the electrical, and another one that is the magnetic component. So this part we already discussed, I'm not going to repeat again. And what about the polarity of this one? The electric field is perpendicular to the magnetic. Okay, so polarity, and now the polarity is over. Now the next part, that is the wavelength. Okay, and we already seen the definition of wavelength also. So wavelength is nothing but it is the distance between two crests. It is the distance between two crests. Means when we are talking about the electromagnetic wave, so frequency is the first term and second one is the wavelength. Now in today's lecture, what we are going to study is what is the relationship between the this frequency and wavelength. Wavelength is denoted by suffix lambda. Okay. And frequency is denoted by somewhere. It is denoted by with L by using the suffix F, or in some books it is they are using the suffix V to indicate the frequency. Okay. So here, what is the relationship between the frequency and wavelength? So on your PPT, you can observe that wavelength is nothing but it is the speed of light divided by frequency. Okay, what is the formula to calculate the wavelength? It is the speed of light divided by the frequency. And wavelength is denoted by suffix lambda. Speed of light, light is here, it is denoted by V, and frequency is denoted by F. Okay, so this is the formula to calculate the wavelength of any waves. Means when we are transmitting the data from transmitter to receiver with the help of some frequency, and that frequency and with the help of that frequency we can calculate the wavelength. Okay, so here what is the speed of light? Speed of light is nothing but we are already aware about that key. It is a a 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters per second. Okay, and it is denoted by the suffix C. So C is nothing but C is equal to lambda by V. Here the V is nothing but, just now I told you, G is nothing but, in some books we are using F for frequency, or in some books we are using the V for the frequency. Okay, so here if I want to establish a relationship between the, if I want to establish a relationship between the this C, lambda and V, so C is nothing but equal to lambda into V, and C is nothing but, it is a speed of light, and which is not, it is a standard, we have the standard value for this one. It is a 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters per second. Lambda, that is the wavelength, which is measured in meters, nanometers, etc., depending upon the frequency. And frequency here, it is denoted by the V. Okay, so I think when we are talking about the electromagnetic waves, so three important terms are there: frequency, wavelength, and third one, that is the speed of light. Okay, and this speed of light is nothing but, it is having standard value, it is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters per second. Lambda is calculated with the help of frequency, and here V is nothing but, it is a frequency. Okay, so now here we are the next one, the next one, that is a in next one, okay, suppose if we want to solve some example on the basis of this formula. Okay, so now suppose just here in this example, that is, wavelength is given, wavelength is 400 nanometer. Okay, so can anybody tell me what is the frequency of this wave? Yes, frequency kitna hoga is wave ka, because we know the formula, C is equal to nothing but, it is a lambda into V, and V is indicated by the frequency. So V is nothing but, V is equal to C divided by lambda, and we know the value of C. So actually this is a 2.998 into 10 raised to 8, it is the actual value, but when we round up this, so we can call it as 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. Okay, so in this case, can anybody tell me what is the value of frequency here? Yes, in this example, what will be the value of frequency here? Yes, anybody can tell me? Yahan par is example mein V ka value kitna hoga? Yes, Bhakti, can you tell me? Kitna aayega value iska? Just switch on your audio.
Sir. Hello, sir.
Haan, bolo.
Your voice is very slow to hear.
What? अच्छा, आवाज ठीक से नहीं आ रहा है क्या? ओके, नाउ इट्स ओके,
आ रही है, बहुत स्लोली आ रही है, कुछ सुनाई नहीं दे रहा है.
अच्छा, इट माइट बी अ नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम.
वॉल्यूम कम है.
अच्छा, सभी का सेम प्रॉब्लम?
वॉल्यूम कम है.
वॉल्यूम जस्ट,
वॉल्यूम हमारा फुल है, आपका आवाज ही नहीं आ रहा है.
जस्ट वेट फॉर सम. Just a minute. अभी ठीक है क्या? यस, आवाज आ रही है अभी?
नहीं सर.
थोड़ा आवाज अः ठीक है, अभी इसमें तो कुछ कर नहीं सकते हैं, लेकिन अभी बाकी लोगों का आ रही है क्या आवाज? बाकी लोग बता सकते हैं क्या? जस्ट दुर्गेश बताओ,
हाँ सर,
आवाज आ रही है क्या?
हाँ सर,
हाँ, तो यू डोंट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम। तो कुछ जगह ठीक है, जिनके पास नेटवर्क वीक रहेगा दे माइट बी फेसिंग वॉइस प्रॉब्लम, ठीक है, तो वो चलता रहेगा। तो वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर लेक्चर, ठीक है। तो जस्ट नाउ आई जस्ट आस्क यू कि व्हाट विल बी द फ्रीक्वेंसी, कि फ्रीक्वेंसी कितना रहेगा। कि अभी मैंने आपके सामने जो स्लाइड शेयर किया था हियर, ओके, कि हियर सी जो है हमारा 3 × 10⁸ है, लैम्बडा है 400। तो इफ वी सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम, ओके, कि इस प्रॉब्लम को अगर हम लोग सॉल्व करते हैं तो व्हाट यू विल गेट, द फ्रीक्वेंसी इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ 7.5 × 10⁴ हर्ट्ज, ओके। So is it clear to all what is the relationship between the speed of light, lambda and frequency, okay? So this is the basic equation which shows the relationship between these three terms, okay? So I think all of got the things. What do you mean by wavelength, what do you mean by frequency, and what is the value of speed of light, okay? Now ye abhi when we are talking about the electromagnetic wave, these three components are very important one. So now what is the significance of all this? There will be a question arise that ki why we are going to study all this, ki agar samjho uska frequency kam ho gaya ya jyada ho gaya, if we increase or decrease the frequency, or if we increase or decrease the wavelength, then what will be the impact, okay? So can anybody tell me what will be the impact, okay, when we increase or decrease the frequency, then what will be the impact, or on which factor it affect, okay? This is what I mean to say, that if we are increase or decrease the frequency, which parameter will be affect, because you are BE student, so we know that what is the impact of frequency on different parameters. So can anybody tell me what will be the impact of frequency on different parameters? Yes, ha Rohit, bolo. Okay, I will give you one clue. Okay, what will be the impact on antenna height? Okay, antenna height का और लैम्बडा का, वेवलेंथ का, व्हाट इज द रिलेशन? एनीबडी नोस? यस, एंटीना हाइट और लैम्बडा का क्या रिलेशन है? सो वी नो दैट कि द स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्मूला फॉर एंटीना हाइट इज नथिंग बट इट इज द लैम्बडा बाय 4, ओके? सो लैम्बडा बाय 4 मींस व्हाट? कि एंटीना हाइट of transmitter is directly proportional to the wavelength of wave, okay? Antenna height is directly proportional to the wavelength of wave, okay? So if we are trying to understand this, what is the relationship between antenna height and wavelength, we know the relationship between the wavelength and frequency. Wavelength or frequency ka jab hum log relations dekhte hain, so here in this relation, in this relationship, f is inversely proportional to the wavelength. Means you have to understood these two terms. F is inversely proportional to the wavelength, and the second thing is that h is directly proportional to wavelength. F frequency jo hai hamara, ye frequency kya hai hamara, वेवलेंथ को इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल है, राइट? सो इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल मींस व्हाट? इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल हम लोग किसको बोलते हैं? यस, वी विल सी वन बाय वन। अभी यहाँ पे हम लोग आपके सामने ये चीज F is equal to V divided by lambda. Now we have this equation. Okay. So here frequency is inversely proportional to wavelength. इसका मीनिंग क्या होता है? यस, कोई बता सकता है कि फ्रीक्वेंसी इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द वेवलेंथ, और वी कैन से वेवलेंथ इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू फ्रीक्वेंसी. तो इन दिस टू सिनेरियो व्हाट इज द एग्जैक्ट मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वन? यस ज्योति, कैन यू टेल मी?
अगर वेवलेंथ बढ़ती है तो फ्रीक्वेंसी कम हो जाती है, फ्रीक्वेंसी बढ़ती है तो वेवलेंथ कम हो जाती है.
ओके, दैट इज द इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल. मतलब क्या कि इफ वी इंक्रीज द फ्रीक्वेंसी तो क्या होगा, वेवलेंथ कम होगी, और इफ वी डिक्रीज द फ्रीक्वेंसी तो वेवलेंथ बढ़ेगी. राइट, सो नाउ दिस इज द वन रिलेशन. सो नाउ वन थिंग इज क्लियर. नाउ सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट हियर एंटीना हाइट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वेवलेंथ. मतलब अगर वेवलेंथ इंक्रीज हो रही है, व्हेन वी इंक्रीज द वेवलेंथ एंटीना हाइट विल बी इंक्रीज, व्हेन वी डिक्रीज द वेवलेंथ एंटीना हाइट विल बी डिक्रीज. सो दिस इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन द एंटीना हाइट एंड वेवलेंथ. दैट इज द, दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट. एंड व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट? दैट इज द वेवलेंथ इज डायरेक्टली, वेवलेंथ इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द फ्रीक्वेंसी. मींस वेवलेंथ कम होगी व्हेन वी इंक्रीज द फ्रीक्वेंसी, वेवलेंथ बढ़ेगी व्हेन वी विल, वेवलेंथ बढ़ेगी व्हेन वी विल डिक्रीज द फ्रीक्वेंसी. नाउ इफ वी फाइंड आउट द कोरिलेशन बिटवीन दिस थ्री टर्म्स, दैट इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी, वेवलेंथ एंड एंटीना हाइट. सो अगर वेवलेंथ बढ़ती है तो एंटीना हाइट बढ़ती है, वेवलेंथ बढ़ती है तो एंटीना हाइट बढ़ती है. राइट, तो अगर वेवलेंथ बढ़ती है तो फ्रीक्वेंसी कम होती है. मतलब इफ वी वांट टू एस्टैब्लिश अ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड एंटीना हाइट, व्हाट यू कैन से दैट? यस, व्हाट यू कैन से दैट? व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन एंटीना हाइट एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी? अभी वी नो द रिलेशन बिटवीन एंटीना हाइट एंड वेवलेंथ. एंटीना हाइट, यू आर गोइंग टू इंक्रीज द वेवलेंथ, देन एंटीना हाइट विल बी इंक्रीज. So what is the relationship between the antenna height and frequency? Kya hoga is case mein? Yes.
Jitni frequency zyada hogi to antenna ki height utni kam hogi.
Yes, that is the, yes, you got the things. So that is the most important part. If we will increase the frequency, then the antenna height will be reduced. Okay. So in this slide, same thing I explained to you. Okay, here in this first one, here we are trying to find out the relationship between these three terms, that is antenna height, wavelength and frequency. Okay, so if you observe this first block, so in this first block, what you can observe here, in first case the frequency is 870 kilohertz. Okay, and here if you will find out the wavelength of this one, how you are going to find out wavelength of this one? Kaise find out karenge hum log? Yes, we know the frequency. Okay, how you are going to find out the wavelength from this frequency? So we know the formula ki wavelength is nothing but it is the speed of light divided by frequency. Okay, so we, by using this formula, we can find out the wavelength of this one. Okay, and once you find out the wavelength, so you can divide that wavelength by four, you will get the antenna height. Okay, so here in this example, if the frequency is 870 kilohertz, in that scenario the antenna height will be 345 meters. The antenna height will be 345 meters, or if you will convert this one, so it will be 1132 feet. Okay, so now this is the first example. In the frequency is 870 kilohertz, so in that scenario the antenna height will be 345 meters. What is the wavelength? You have to calculate. Okay, so kaise calculate karenge? 870, we know the formula how to calculate the wavelength. Okay, that is the 3 × 10⁸ divided by 870 kilohertz, so you will get that wavelength. And if you divide that wavelength by 4, then you will get this antennae. Okay, now this is the first block. Okay, so now the second thing is that what I am trying to do here, I am going to increase the frequency. Means earlier it is 870 kilohertz, now I have a wave which is having the 8 megahertz frequency. So what will be the antenna height? Yes, here we have the 299 meters. If you convert this one, it may be 981 feet. Okay, so now again, if we'll further, I will increase the frequency. Further, I will increase the frequency. Then what happens? Again, the antenna height will be decreased up to 29.9 centimeters. Okay, so if the frequency will be 1 gigahertz. Again, if I will increase the antenna height, again I will increase the frequency, so it will be 23 gigahertz. Okay, so if I will increase the frequency up to 23 gigahertz, then what will be the antenna height? It is a 13 millimeter. Yes, so are you got the relationship between the antenna height and frequency? Okay, so from this slide. So now we are getting that key just I shown. If there's a many apparatus, we have the lower frequency, antenna height will be more. If we have the higher frequency, then antenna height will be lowest. Okay. So now this is the correlation between frequency or in frequency and antenna height. Okay. So if we are increasing the frequency, then what happens? The wavelength is going to decrease. Wavelength is going to decrease, and wavelength is will be decreased, then antenna height will be, yes. Agar, if I will increase the frequency, wavelength kya hoga? Decrease hoga. Or antenna height kya hoga? Whether it will be increase or decrease. If you will give this answer, then I can understood that this concept is clear. Yes. If I will increase the frequency, अगर मैं फ्रीक्वेंसी को इंक्रीज करता हूं, इफ आई विल इंक्रीज द फ्रीक्वेंसी, देन व्हाट विल बी द इंपैक्ट ऑन एंटीना हाइट? यस रोहित, कैन यू टेल मी, इफ आई विल इंक्रीज द फ्रीक्वेंसी, देन व्हाट विल बी द इंपैक्ट ऑन एंटीना हाइट? यस रोहित, ऑडियो ऑन करो तुम्हारा. Yes, anyone can tell me. Bolo Rohit. Yes, Durgesh, can you tell me, if I will increase the frequency, what will be the impact on antenna height?
If frequency increase, then height of antenna may be decrease.
Antenna height will be decreased. So what is the significance of this one? If when we are talking about TV channel communication, so the frequency is in megahertz. We know the frequency band for the multimedia communication, that is the 5 megahertz frequency band. Okay, so when we are talking about this mobile phone, agar 5 megahertz agar frequency hamara hai, तो उसके लिए वी नो दैट कि अर्लियर वी हैव टू एस्टैब्लिश अ वेरी ह्यूज एंटीना, कि आपको एक बड़ा वाला एंटीना एस्टैब्लिश करना पड़ता था. आपने देखा होगा पहले वाले जो एंटीना थे कि उसका हाइट 10 मीटर्स, 20 मीटर्स, 30 मीटर्स इतना होता था. ओके, सो व्हाई? बिकॉज द फ्रीक्वेंसी इज लोअर वन. जो पुराने वाले जो टीवी थे, ओल्ड, अगर हम लोग पुराने जो टीवी हैं तो वो यागी हुड एंटीना आता था, एक वर्टिकल बार होता था, है ना, उसको हॉरिजॉन्टल बार्स हम लोग प्लेस करते थे. तो इफ सो इन ओल्ड एज, सो द एंटीना हाइट विल बी वेरी व्हाट आई कैन से, इट इज अ वी रिक्वायर्ड अ ह्यूज एंटीना हाइट. बट नाउअडेज व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द मोबाइल फोन, यस डेफिनेटली अवर मोबाइल फोन इज हैविंग द एंटीना. ओके, बट वी कैन नॉट फील इट बिकॉज द एंटीना हाइट इज वेरी लो. In this slide, just we discuss about this one, ki if the frequency is in gigahertz, so what will be the height of antenna? So it is nothing but it is up to only 30 सेंटीमीटर ओके सो यू कैन इमेजिन दैट 30 सेंटीमीटर इज मींस इट इज नथिंग बट ऑन योर फिंगर टिप ओके वी कैन जस्ट यूज द एंटीना सो मींस दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर और वी कैन से दैट इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कोरिलेशन इफ वी विल इंक्रीज if we will increase the frequency of wave if we will increase the frequency of wave then antenna height will be decreased so what is the significance of this one so because nowadays everywhere we are trying to establish a communication between the source and destination a transmitter and receiver and if when we are trying to transmit the electromagnetic wave from transmitter to receiver if that electromagnetic wave is having lower frequency in that scenario what happens if the frequency is lower so for the communication we need a huge transmitter antenna or transmit antenna and we again we require the huge receiver antenna so means ultimately the cost will be increased maintenance will be increased and the quality of service is also decrease okay because we required the huge amount of money to establish those things and if we will do this data transmission by using the higher frequency then what happens the antenna height will be decreased and ultimately the cost will be reduced and the quality of service will be again improved so that this is a very important factor which affect the overall communication process okay so just we have the 2-3 minutes so just I will conclude the today's lecture okay when we are trying to transmit the signal from source to destination we require the transmitter as well as receiver transmitter as well as receiver transmitter definitely requires the transmit antenna receiver requires the receive antenna okay And the height of that antenna will be depend upon the wavelength of electromagnetic waves. And we know the relationship between the frequency, wavelength, and antenna height. We know that the wavelength is inversely proportional to frequency, and height of antenna is directly proportional to the wavelength. Means ultimately, if we are going to increase the frequency the antenna height will be decreases so because in our chapter in our subject radiation and microwave techniques the microwaves are having very high frequencies and to transmit this signal from source to destination we have the first in our syllabus we have the first two chapter based on antenna so we should know the core concept of antenna means what is the relation between frequency wavelength and antenna so when we interconnect all these three things so we will come to know that frequency increase antenna height decrease frequency decrease antenna height will be increased okay so in the next lecture we will see the different types of antenna Faraday's equation and how we are communicating or what are the different methods to communicate between a transmitter and receiver what are the different types of communication so it means line of sight communication satellite communication anospheric communication so that we will see one by one but up till now it's supposed to be clear that what is the electromagnetic wave and what are the terms which are related to that one that is the wavelength and frequency and what is the relation between all these three most important parameter okay so yes just we have only 2 minutes so anybody is having any questions yes so for some student you are not getting the audio clear audio ठीक से नहीं आ रहा है so that may be a network problem तो उसको हम कुछ नहीं कर सकते but anything else So just I will summarize this one. I will ask some question to you. Batai answer. Yes, Sakshi, can you tell me what is the definition of frequency? Yes, switch on your audio. फ्रीक्वेंसी का डेफिनेशन बोलो. यस, व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी? यस, एनीवन कैन टेल मी व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी? ज्योति? Yes, the session
number of cycle in 1 second.
Number of cycle. What is the definition of wavelength? Wavelength ka kya definition hai? Yes, Durgesh, bolo. What is the definition of wavelength? Yes, audio on karo, Durgesh. Or anyone, Siddharam, can you tell me the definition of wavelength? Yes. Okay, so we know that k wavelength is nothing but it is the distance between two crests. Okay, and what is the relationship between the frequency and wavelength? That is, wavelength lambda is equal to c divided by f. Right, c is nothing but it is the speed of light. And what is the relationship between antenna height and wavelength? H is equal to lambda by 4. So these three important equations are there. So with this, can I conclude the lecture? So would we stop here? Yes. Okay, so thanks. In next lecture we will talk about the different ionospheric communication. Okay, so we will stop here. Okay, thanks for attending the lecture.